Guys, so our guest has already arrived and he is, all of you know.
Yeah, hi. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Namaste.
Yeah, welcome. Hi.
Namaste, sir.
Hello,
welcome to Talking Nepal.
Hi. Hi, thank you. You are Suprema. Hi, Suprema.
Hi, sir. Suprema. I'm Suprema. And I would like to introduce you to our audiences. Actually, you know, you need no introduction today. This is the best thing I've ever announced in my entire life. So today, the guest we have is Mr. Ram Potineni. He is an Indian film actor who is known for his works in Telugu cinema. He made his debut with Devadasu in 2016, which won him a Filmfare Award for Best Male Debut South. And he started his career at the age of 11 and is a recipient of numerous national and international awards. He is known for his contribution to social causes, including support to Swachh Bharat campaigns. So I would like to welcome him again in today's event. So how are you, sir? Ram, sir?
I'm doing great. Hello, Nepal. How are you all? I see a lot of people chatting on there. Hi, hi, hi.
Actually, you know what? I'd like to first of all welcome you, and I hope you're fine. And before you arrived in this Zoom platform, the chat box was full fill, and still the chat box is filled with the name Ram Potineni, Ram Potineni, Ram Potineni.
Thank you all for your love. Thank you all for your love.
Thank you so much for being with us, sir. And we will have a question answer series now. And for the sessions will be moderated by Mr. Biplav Kargi, who invited you in today's event. And I would like to thank him and thanks to you as well for joining with us. So Biplav Kargi, can we have you?
Yeah, surely.
Hi, Mr. Kargi.
Hello, Ram sir. Nice to see you. Yeah. So they said that I'll be moderating this session, but like a fan asking question to his idol is the something that is being done now. So I'm a little nervous too. So like maybe I need to talk this, but even though I don't understand any of South Indian language, literally, except Namaskaram, I don't understand any South Indian language, but still I watch all the movies, all the songs of your, and I watch all those movies with English subtitles, and the songs need no language. The music itself feels like I need to dance, even though I don't know how to dance. It makes me feel like I need to dance. So yeah, thank you so much for joining us. And thanks to also Krishna sir for helping us to have you in this session. So without further delay, because you don't have much time and audience wants to hear from you, so let's start from the basic thing. Like this, just you can just analyze the basic journey of you, like what made you pursue your career towards acting from such an early age of almost 11. Like what drove you in to become an actor?
Yeah, so 11 was when I started acting. I don't even remember when I wanted to become an actor. So ever since I could remember, I wanted to become an actor. So I had only one vision, and that's what I've been following ever since. And because I knew it at an early age, I had a lot of time to work on it. So at 11, when I got the opportunity to work in a short film, so this was way back in 2000. So 2000 was when YouTube wasn't there and people did not understand the concept of a short film. But then I just acted in it for experience, you know, because back then you didn't have these small cameras. Even a short film, you had to shoot with a proper, you know, big film camera and stuff. You had like a film unit and stuff. So I basically did it for an experience, and then it got selected in an international award, international film festival, and then I ended up getting an award, and that's how my entire journey began. So at 11 I acted, but I wanted to become an actor ever since I could remember.
Yeah.
So that's been the journey.
Can you hear me? I think so.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, okay.
So I see a lot of Indians also.
So yeah. Yeah.
Hi to all my like fans.
This is, I think we are more Indians than Nepalese here. I feel so. Because you can see the population as well as your fans there.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's not only talk about those acting things, because this is an event where we have been pitching all those ideas. In the daytime, we had all the entrepreneurs, or you can say the aspiring youths who wants to make a change to the society, and the theme was itself a food.
Yeah.
But yeah, like every actor is called himself as an entrepreneur because they have been doing something that other people could not have done easily. Or so, like, how do you define that word of entrepreneurship or say an entrepreneur?
I don't know if every actor is an entrepreneur, but so you may not be knowing, I produce most of my films as well. So I could relate a startup or a company to a film, you know, where it's a product. It starts off with an idea, and then you have a team, and then you discuss the ideas, you grow the idea, and then you get funding, and then you market it, you promote it, and then you have investors coming in, like distributors, you know, like you have investors coming in, believing in your idea, betting on it, and finally you let it out to the public. So I think more than an actor, I have also been an entrepreneur, being a producer as well. Yeah, a movie. I see a movie like a startup, you know what I mean? It all starts off with an idea.
Yeah.
So that's how it starts. So, and
as you say, like,
and also, it starts off with an idea. You know, it's not about making money. You know, it's not like a couple of people sit down like, okay, let's make money. No, it's about, I have an idea. You know, how do we get this idea? You're all excited about that idea. And then that idea drives the entire thing. You know, people who connect with that idea join you slowly. You know, I also believe in that idea. You join. And then you become a team, and then you pitch that idea, and that's how it grows. So entrepreneurship is quite similar to what a producer does. That's how a startup is as well, right? If a producer is technically an entrepreneur that way.
Yeah, that sounds fascinating. Like, I also analyze this, like, movie sounds like a startup idea, and like the actors and actresses can be like the CEO and founders, and the investors are professors. So it really relates with movie when it talks to startup and entrepreneurship. So yeah. Like talking about entrepreneurship, so the youths, like, one of the biggest fear that youths have is that they can't be a leader themselves. They fear to take lead to do something, or maybe start their own, as well as maybe do what they have been passionate about. So what's your advice to all those youth who really want to be a leader but are still frightened because of society, maybe because of their parents, anything? So what's your suggestion to anyone who wants to be a leader and are still frightened on that?
So basically, can you hear me? I think the signal's pretty weak. Can you hear me?
Am I audible? Yeah, I can hear you. Yes.
Yeah, I can hear you. So I think that's a very... that's a very difficult question to answer, because that is not the drive with which you have to go. Like, no one should sit and wonder if I should become a leader or not. See, a leader is nobody. He's just a person who has a vision. You know, if I have a vision to do something, it could be starting off an idea. It could be starting off a movement. You know, whatever it is, I have a vision and I want to follow it. And I go towards that vision, and people who also believe in that ideology follow me. That is the leader. So,
yeah.
A person becomes a leader. You know, you just don't sit and wonder if you be a leader or not. And about being scared of becoming a leader, I think how strong your vision is and how strongly you want that or that idea to materialize. How do you become a leader? It's like, how do you make that vision happen? How strongly are you attached to that vision? You know, how strong is your vision and how strong is your motivation towards making that vision into reality? I think that just gives you the strength, the motivation, everything. So that's how leaders are born. You know, leaders are not made, they're born. Like, they have a vision and they just go towards it. So I think just have a great vision, and then be committed to it. So just don't care about anything else. Just go, and then there will be people who will join you. And eventually you will take care of them, because everybody wants, like, people who join you want to make that vision happen as well. So you are bound to show love. You are bound to make that happen.
Yeah, like as you said, leadership is not just like motivating yourself, it's like motivating others. So you yourself cannot be frightened of executing something. So being a leader is a different thing.
If I really want change, or if I really believe in an idea, so I just go towards it, like relentlessly, just go towards it, make it happen. That's all I want to do. And people who believe in me follow me. And because their idea is also the same, that's when you develop leadership qualities. Leadership qualities is nothing but, you know, showing your, like, it's teamwork, basically. You make your entire team work together because your idea, your vision is so important to you. So I don't think nobody should sit down and wonder, okay, I want to be a leader. What should I lead? No, it's about what do I want in life? How badly do I want it? And I'm going to lead the way. And I'm going to wait for people to join me. You know, leader never thinks of followers. He thinks, you know, these people are helping me with my vision. So that's how you become a leader.
Yeah, so that sounds really motivating. So let's talk about the theme of the program itself. So this year, AltPrize had a theme of food for good. So our all brilliant people came up with various ideas to solve the problems of food, like malnutrition, supply chain, and they have brilliant ideas the whole day. So what do you think about the food problems of the society, as India also has a lot of problems in that domain? So what do you think about the food problems of the society and how youths like us and you, because you are registered for youth as the most energetic star. So how can youths like us solve those problems of food of the society?
I'm losing it. I just lost you there for a second. Could you just repeat the last one?
Yeah, like how do you motivate youths to solve the problems? So how do, what are your views on the problems of food? Yeah, mm-hmm. And how can youths try to solve that? In your views,
food problem, I'm sure there are other ways, but if you look at the macro thinking, like macro analysis, so I don't think there's food scarcity, because I think it's about poverty more than food, because there is enough food for people to waste. Like people with money have enough food to waste. Food is not like oil, you know what I mean? Like there's no scarcity, like you don't know there's limit. No, tend to grow, but it's all about money. Like people who can afford food can afford to waste it. People who can't afford food can't afford to eat it. So I think it's more about money wise than food wise. But again, yeah, I think you guys are coming up with great supply chain ideas and all of that. But macro analysis, like how I see it, I think it's still about, it's all about poverty, I guess. So you have enough money, you get food. If you have too much money, you have enough food to waste it. So like there's scarcity when even rich people can't afford to waste it, you know what I mean? That's when the real scarcity comes from.
Yeah.
So right now I think it's all about balance. You know, there is food, it's you just don't have money to go get it, you know what I mean? So
yeah, like as you said, most of them were also motivated to solve the problems, that balancing thing, like rich have a lot of food to eat, the poor don't have food
also,
to eat.
And also I think, you know, it's, you know, earlier before all this globalization, all that happened, you have your local people making food, you know, that's like everyone, they had their own villages, they were making their own food, they were self-sufficient.
Yeah.
I think every country, every government, they needs to, it's food. So I'm sure that there is a lot of population and all that, but by the end of the day, there are ways to cultivate enough food, and you know, you have to be self-sufficient. You shouldn't, like even for food, you shouldn't be dependent on other countries and stuff. You know what I mean? Like use the local ingredients, like have your own local food, like support your local guy, local farmers, your local grocery store, whatever it is, your entire supply chain. I think you need to go local and become self-sufficient. And whatever your country is good for, that's when you have to, like, you know, go beyond that. But I think food is one of the basic necessities, and I think it all comes down to money. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, like that's really true also. Even our judges said same, there is no scarcity of food. This all the unbalanced ecosystem that exists in our society. So that was the main problem. And you also said the same, that really motivates. So yeah, like let's talk about something of your own personal. Like I found this really amazing, because we all are from engineering background also. So most of them here are from engineering background. So like you have been a gadget lover since a long, like I also heard that you have already changed almost 100 plus mobile phones. So what is
I'm also playing an engineer in my next film.
In the Raid, yeah. In Raid movie, I think most of them have already known. So it will be releasing in early 2021.
I'm mentioning this because, yeah, it's going to release in Jan, hopefully.
Yeah.
So there's also dialogue and engineers that I want each and every engineer to listen to because they really enjoy it.
yeah. Everyone will surely buzz. We don't need to say also. yeah. So like, yeah, what drives you to,
especially this engineering thing.
Yeah. So what drives you to change, like love towards your gadget? What is the main thing that you really like playing with gadgets and all those things?
So I've always been a gadget lover. Like I love technology. So I just love how it just makes life more easier. Like for example, this lockdown, So I've been watching so much of, I've been using my phone so much that I wanted to do a detox on my phone. Like, I'm like, I'm watching too much screen. Like, I'm not going to use my phone for 2 days. And then I realized the importance of a phone. Like, I'm technically handicapped. Like, I want to order something, it's my phone. I want to do some transaction, it's on my phone. You know, your phone is not just to make calls anymore. You know, your life stops running if you take a detox from your phone. So that's all that, it's all about technology and, you know, how it's, we're so dependent on it right now, which is a good thing and a bad thing. But I've always been fascinated by gadgets and any new technology that comes up. So, okay. Yeah,
so that's it. So I don't think we have much time. So let me ask one last question from my side. Then after we'll see how much time we have for any other 1 to 2 person if they have interaction. So like as a last word, so any advice to youths and students like who are paving their path to any of their dream? Doesn't matter which field they are, doesn't matter which course they are, doesn't matter from where they are. So what's your advice so that they become success in their life like you have been a success in all over the world? So what's your advice to them to so that they can be successful in their life?
So what I believe is what I've seen personally, like I can only say about what I've seen personally, but I think a lot of people give up too easily. So I think you should always have a plan B in life. You know, plan A, try to make it happen. If plan A doesn't work, stop, analyze it, and then use plan B to make plan A work again. You know, I've never believed in plan B as in, I've always believing in having one dream and just going and achieving it, you know, go all out and achieve it. Like, for example, I was an actor. So acting is not an easy profession, you know, for parents to accept. When I told my parents when I was really young, so they wanted me to study so that I have something to fall back upon. You know, as parents, that's their concern. You know what I mean? Like, what if acting doesn't work? You know, become an engineer or a doctor or whatever it is. You know, some in case this doesn't work, you have something back to fall back, you know, something to fall back upon. I, even as a kid, I was around 8 or 9 back then, but I've never believed in that concept because for me, it was just acting or die trying. You know, it's like get rich or die trying. But here it's not about the money. It's about the passion. It's about your dream. You know, try to achieve it. Or I'm going to try. Like, what would you do if you weren't an actor? I would still be trying to become an actor. You know, that is one goal. So I went and asked my mom again. So they said they asked me to study engineering or whatever, you know, just to have something to fall back upon. So I was like, if I want to become a doctor, would you ask me to study engineering so that I'll have something else to fall back upon? No. You know what I mean? So for me, acting, I give acting that much importance. For me, it's like you're studying medicine, you're becoming an engineer, you're becoming a doctor. For me, I want to become an actor. So no matter what it is, that is exactly what I'm going to do. So plan B is there, but plan B is not plan running away from your dream. Plan B is the space you take from plan A when it fails and then implement it again in a better way, so to see how plan A works again. So I think people give up too easily. So I don't think you should give up that easily and always have a plan B to make your plan A work again.
Yeah, like this was the most valuable thing that you said of plan A and B. So this will really inspire all those things, all those youths to motivate. So yeah, Suprema, like he doesn't have so much of time. So let's pick 1 to 2, any question or any of audience who wants to really talk to him. So maybe someone are raising hand, you can choose from them. Just unmute them and only if they have good network, let them speak because he doesn't have much time. And so we need to wrap up fast.
Okay, I think better than me, Ram sir should choose by himself because
I don't know how to choose. I don't know how this works.
Okay,
let's do like there are people from India, so let's choose one Nepalese and one Indian to talk with him. So that
yeah,
maybe
you
that
can pick,
be
you can pick whoever thing. Because I don't know how to choose all that.
I choose Arun Bhatta.
Okay, so let me
Arun Bhatta.
Arun Bhatta. So Arun,
hello
Arun, yeah, please ask anything if you want.
Hi Arun, I can't see you, but hi, can you hear me?
I think he was there but he dropped somewhere.
Please not waste time here. I will choose next, Bibek Malik.
Okay, sure.
Hello Ram sir.
Hi, Vivek. How are you?
Hello.
I am fine. How are you, sir?
Doing good.
So just go I want on. To say that I want to say that we all are huge fan of yours, sir, here. And
thank you. Thank you.
I would like to thank you from the bottom of my heart to so the bottom of my heart for accepting our invitations. Actually, I am the deputy campus director of Hall Prize at IOE.
Okay, sir.
And your presence has just boosted the level of our event, sir.
Oh, thank you so much. It's an honor. It's an honor being.
Big thanks, sir.
He himself seems to be nervous because he's talking to such a great fan of himself. Yeah, so yeah, even I'm nervous.
It's natural. It's natural, man.
Please tell me. Please tell.
Okay, Suprema, let's choose one. Maybe I see her. Pooja is really excited and have been waving hands. So Pooja, I'll unmute her. Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Ram.
Hi. Sorry, I didn't get your name.
Pooja. It's Pooja. I'm from
Pooja,
Mumbai.
Hi. Hi, Pooja.
Oh my god. I just can't believe you. Can you see me now?
Not really, but
okay. It's okay.
Go on.
Oh my god. Yeah, I just can't believe.
Oh yes, hi.
Yeah, hi. Hi. Okay, now I can't see you, but it's fine.
I just hi. Yeah, you can yeah, ask yeah, question
yeah.
first.
Yeah. So yeah. I actually
I think I lost you there.
Sorry,
she got muted herself or something.
Pooja? Did you choose someone? Or...
Hello. Yeah. I just want to say that you always meet your fans in Hyderabad, and you never come to meet your fans in Mumbai. But you come to Mumbai a lot. I know that because I've seen your photos on the airport a lot.
Okay.
So, yeah. So like.
I will plan next time. I will plan. I will let you guys know when I'm in
like,
Mumbai.
Like meet me. And, it's okay if you don't meet anyone else. Just meet me. So like
I will meet you and everyone like you.
Yeah. It's okay. So what have you been up to like in the lockdown?
Yeah.
What have I been up to in the lockdown?
Long time.
I think this is the interesting question. This is a really interesting question. Like everyone asks, like how did you spend the lockdown?
Oh,
like,
honestly, it's the most boring answer. Very interesting question. Most boring answer has been just chilling at home, and I've been listening to a lot of scripts and watched a couple of movies and spent a lot of family time, and that's about it.
Okay. Yeah.
I've done an ad in between somewhere first time.
Okay, so yeah, I think that sounds very interesting. Like as Pooja just said, you'll be visiting Mumbai someday. So what's your plan? Maybe you should also visit Nepal. We should meet for real also someday. So do
Definitely.
You have any plan
Definitely.
Of Nepal? And how much do you have knowledge on Nepal? Can you share?
So my mom, she's been to Nepal a couple of times. So she keeps talking about it. And definitely, I would love to visit Nepal. I love traveling.
So
and I'd love
hope
to
someday.
Nepal. I will visit Nepal one day.
Yeah, surely. And I'll just ping Krishna sir to meet you if you come to Nepal.
Please. Yes.
I think Suprema, now I think we need to end because he's already 5 minutes more than expected. So
no problem. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you all so much. It was an honor being here. And thank you, Karki. I can't see.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Love and Ram sir, I wish this session was longer, for more than an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. But sadly, we don't have much time. Ram sir don't have much time because he's a busy person and he has a lot of works in his life to do. That is why he is admired and loved by not only us but his entire nation and entire internationally. So thank you so much, Ram sir, for being with us. And
thank you.
So let's take a selfie, virtual selfie before he leaves. Suprema, please. Let's do that. Okay, let's do that. So everyone wants to take a virtual selfie with Ram sir, please open your camera. This is a lifetime opportunity.
Great.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you all so much. Thank you, Nepal. And thanks to all my fans in India, all over. I can see you guys here and there. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much. It was lovely being
Thank
here.
You, sir.
Lovely talking.
Take care. Bye.